Assalamu alaikum. My name is Tahir Hussain and today our subject is psychometric chart. Psychometric chart is very important to design the air conditioning system. From the psychometric chart we can know many properties of the air and it will help you for our designing of the air conditioning system. First we will see what is the psychometric chart. The psychometric is the science dealing with the physical law of air water mixture. When designing an air conditioning system, the temperature and moisture content of the air to be conditioned and the same properties of the air needed to produce the desired air conditioning effect must be known. Once these properties are known, the air conditioning task can be determined. This analysis can be performed using the psychometric chart. In the psychometric chart, we will see the air properties, the dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, relative humidity, humidity ratio, dew point temperature, specific enthalpy and specific volume. So this is a psychometric chart. In the psychometric chart there are many lines we cannot see here very clear, and we will see in the next we will explain. I will show you all the lines in details. So here horizontal is the dry bulb temperature, here is the wet bulb temperature. Like this, you see this red line, this is the wet bulb temperature. So this is the humidity ratio, this is enthalpy, and this is the relative humidity, this blue line, this is the relative humidity. And this is psychometric chart, you can see the many formulas here which is very useful for the air conditioning system. When you are designing the air conditioning, so this formula are very helpful for your air conditioning system designing. So this is the psychometric chart. We will see the again. So first we will see the air properties. Air is made up of 5 main gases: nitrogen 78%, oxygen 20.99%, argon 0.94%, carbon dioxide 0.03%, and hydrogen 0.01% by volume. The ideal gas laws are used to determine psychometric data for air so that the engineer can carry out calculations. To make life easier, a chart has been compiled with all the relevant psychometric data indicated. This is called the psychometric chart. The first property what we will discuss now, the dry bulb temperature. The dry bulb temperature reading given by a dry thermometer. This is the thermometer. Normally we are using this dry thermometer. That gives a direct indication as to the sensible heat content of air. It is very important to understand the sensible heat and the latent heat. There is two types of heat. So sensible heat means when the temperature is shown on the thermometer, increase or decrease. And latent heat where the phase is changed. We are supplying the heat but temperature is not increasing on the thermometer. This is the latent heat. So dry bulb temperature gives the direct indication of sensible heat content of air. How much the sensible heat in the air? Dry bulb temperature is ambient air temperature measured during a normal thermometer, like this thermometer, freely exposed to the air. But shielded from the radiation and moisture. Shielded from radiation and moisture means when you are measuring the dry bulb temperature, your thermometer should not be near to the like fireplace. To avoid the radiation and moisture, anywhere like washroom where is more moisture and more moisture place, you have to be freely placed and you have to be avoid the radiation and the moisture. Now we will see the chart. These vertical lines are dry bulb temperature lines. If you see all the vertical line in the psychometric chart, these are the dry bulb lines shown. So we will go now for the next, the wet bulb temperature. The wet bulb temperature whose bulb is covered by a wet wick. You see this wet wick, the cloth. This is the bulb of the wet bulb thermometer and it is covered by the wet cloth. The difference between the wet bulb temperature and dry bulb temperature is caused by the cooling effect produced by the evaporation of moisture from the wick. What is happening? When this cloth is wet and the evaporation starts, the cooling effect produced here on the bulb of the thermometer. When the cooling effect produced on the bulb, so what will happen? The thermometer reading will be decreased. This evaporation effect reduces the temperature of the bulb and therefore the thermometer reading come. We will see the difference between the dry bulb and wet bulb temperature reading is a measure of dryness of air. The drier the air, the greater the difference between the dry bulb and wet bulb reading. If the air is more dry, this difference, this is the dry bulb thermometer and this is the wet bulb, it is covered by the wet cloth. If the air is more dry, this difference, which we call the depression, will be more. Why we put wet cloth with bulb of thermometer? When the air comes, see, this is the air is coming and it is touching with the wet cloth and it is contact with the wet cloth. What happened? Evaporation of the water or moisture that is available in the wet cloth will start from the cloth. Then cooling effect will generate on the wet bulb. Here the cooling effect will be generated. Because of this cooling effect, temperature becomes lower than the dry bulb temperature. Difference between dry bulb and wet bulb is called depression. This is the depression. Wet bulb temperature is directly proportional to humidity of surrounding air. So wet bulb temperature is directly proportional to the humidity of the surrounding air. If humidity will be more, then wet bulb temperature will be more. Because if there is more humidity, there will be no evaporation more. So what will happen? The no cooling effect will be more. So this temperature will be not reduced. Because if this air will be more dry, evaporation will happen more and the cooling effect will produce here. When the cooling effect will produce here, the temperature will be decreased. So if there is less evaporation and reading will not come down from thermometer, suppose there is 100% humidity in the surrounding air, the difference between dry bulb and wet bulb temperature will be zero. That means depression will be zero and there is no evaporation and no cooling on the bulb of thermometer. So these are the wet bulb temperatures lines in the psychometric chart. We will see now dew point temperature. The third property, dew point temperature, is the temperature at which moisture leaves the air. You see the moisture, this moisture available in the air. When the air will be saturated. At which moisture leaves the air and condenses on objects, just a dew forms, grass or plant leaves. When the dry bulb, wet bulb and dew point temperature are the same, the air is same mean the air is fully saturated. The air is saturated, it can hold no more moisture. When the air is saturated condition, moisture entering the air displaces moisture within the air. So displaced moisture leave the air in the form of fine droplets. When this condition occurs in nature, it is called fog. And when the dry bulb, wet bulb and dew point temperature will be same, so what will happen? The moisture will leave the air, displace it, it will come outside. So it is called the fog also. We see the fog also in the air. So this is the dew point temperature, the lines, horizontal lines, this is the dew point temperature. Now we'll see the relative humidity. The fourth property, relative humidity, is a comparison of the amount of moisture that a given amount of air is holding to the amount of moisture that the same amount of air can hold at the same dry bulb temperature. It is very important to understand the same dry bulb temperature. For example, I have the air and it is holding some 50% moisture. And the same dry bulb temperature, it can hold 100% the moisture saturated condition. The ratio of these two one is the relative humidity. So relative humidity in the psychometric chart is shown like these lines, in the curved lines, the relative humidity. Now we'll see the humidity ratio. Finally, humidity ratio describes the actual weight of water in air. Actually, this is the humidity ratio, the weight of water in air, water vapor mixture. In other words, if we have this one pond of air were wrung completely dry, and it means that we will remove the water from the air, comparing the weight of the water to the weight of the dry air would yield the humidity ratio. So we will see how much the weight of the water which removed from this air, one pond of air, and how much the weight of the dry air now. So there are 7,000 grains in one pond of air. So this is the humidity ratio. In the psychometric chart, humidity ratio is shown like this. It is available. The reading is always written here on this side. So we will see now the enthalpy. What is enthalpy? Enthalpy is total heat of air, sensible plus latent heat. So what is sensible heat? sensible heat, as I told you, changes in temperature that do not alter the moisture content of the air, do not change the phase, but the temperature will be, if increase or decrease, it will be shown on the thermometer. Latent heat related to level of moisture in the air. There is a specific amount of energy. This is very, now we will discuss now enthalpy little bit in detail. There is specific amount of energy in the air water vapor mixture at a specific temperature. The energy of this mixture is dependent on two measures. So we are talking, if there is air, in the air there is energy. This energy dependent on two factors, the temperature of the air, the proportion of water vapor in the air. If there is more energy in the air at higher temperature, if the air has the more temperature, it has more energy, it can absorb more moisture. The addition of heat to raise the temperature is called adding sensible heat. There is also more energy when there is more water vapor in the air. If there is more water vapor in the air, so there is energy also. Air gets the more energy. The energy that water vapor contains is referred to as latent heat. The energy of air getting by water vapor is called latent heat. The measure of the total energy of both the sensible in the air and the latent in the water vapor is commonly called enthalpy. Enthalpy can be raised by adding energy to the mixture of the dry air and water vapor. So if we can increase the enthalpy, if the air will be more hot, or by mixture of the water vapor. So enthalpy in the psychometric chart is shown like this line. This is the enthalpy readings at this point. These are the enthalpy readings. Specific volume. This is the volume of moist air, dry air plus water vapor per unit volume, mass. Specific volume, actually it is the reciprocal of density also. So if you see the specific volume, it is the reciprocal. What is the density? Mass per unit volume. And what is specific volume? Volume per unit mass. This is the specific volume, and specific volume in the psychometric chart is shown like these lines. Now we will study the psychometric chart, and we will see one example also in the psychometric chart. In the psychometric chart, what is happening, we will discuss in the short way. Vertical movement. What mean of vertical movement? If you will go in the psychometric chart like this, vertical. So what happened? Change in moisture, and moisture is related to latent heat. If in the psychometric chart, I will show you now. This is the psychometric chart. If we will go like this, vertical, the moisture is going to change. If we will go up, more humidity, because relative humidity is going to increase. Here 100%, this is the saturation line. If we will come down, the air will be dehumidifying. If we will go right side, more heat, mean sensible heat is increasing. If you will see the temperature here also below, you will see the temperature is going to increase horizontally, right hand side. And here, if we will go to the left hand side, the air is going to be cool, less sensible heat. So we'll go the our last slides. So down, dehumidifying mean remove moisture, decrease the humidity ratio. Humidity, if we'll go up, it is increased because of the relative humidity increase, it means latent heat. Horizontal movement, as we discussed, change in temperature. If we'll go to the left, it will be cool. If we'll go to the right, it will be hot. Any more sensible heat will be added. So we already discussed this chart also. So we will see now one example. For example, I have the air and the room condition. Room condition, I have the air 75 Fahrenheit and 50% relative humidity. So this is the 75, the dry bulb temperature. This is the dry bulb temperature 75, and relative humidity 50%. This is the relative humidity. You see the line. This is the 50% relative humidity, and this is the point where these two points join. This is the point. Now first we will see wet bulb temperature. So our wet bulb temperature will be, this is the line, is 62.8, like this going. This is the wet bulb. Humidity ratio, our horizontal line, this is the humidity ratio line. So this is our humidity, 0.0094 at this condition. Humidity ratio, dew point temperature will be 55. This is our dew point, the 55 will be the dew point temperature. Enthalpy will be 28.2 BTU per pound. So this is our enthalpy value. This is the line of the enthalpy value. Then we have the specific volume. Specific volume, this is the line. Specific volume, this is the 13.68 cubic foot per pore. In the psychometric chart, if you know the two values, you can find another all the values of the air properties. Here, like room condition, we have the two values, dry bulb temperature and relative humidity, so we can find other values also. So this is as we discussed before also. So latent heat is vertically movement. It will go up, the latent heat will be increased. It will go down, the latent heat will be decreased. So it is going in the vertical movement. Sensible heat, it is going to the horizontal. It will go to the right, sensible heat is going to increase. Temperature is going to increase, it will go left, that sensible heat is going to decrease, and temperature is also decreased. So this was the psychometric chart. I hope you understand the psychometric chart. Thank you.